I am your host, Chapatti, and we are in Bangalore, India. Mr. Yachindra Das,
yes,
who's come from a very traditional Ayurvedic treatment.
People here understand the importance of movement and exercise and taking walks in the woods. There's a folk tradition of folk medicine and herbs and healthy eating that many people are interested in.
And this one, real ginger, yeah?
Ginger.
Yeah.
It's very good for digestion.
Yeah. You can, wherever there is a skin disease, you can just apply neem oil.
And the more blood circulation you have, the more oxygen you have in your body, the more healthier your organs will be.
Prana and energy, it is a very key point in yoga, yes?
Yes. And so what? When the prana is high, when the life force is high within us, then depression fades away, it goes away.
What is a way to strengthen our lungs? Like you said, breath work.
Breath work.
Breathing exercises.
Mm-hmm.
Yoga.
Mm-hmm.
Tai Chi, Qigong.
By changing the rhythm of the breath and by breaking the flow of the breath, we can have an impact on our own mind.
My own experience from going through my own return to wellness, the more we're disconnected from source, the more unpleasant things or unstagnated energy happens.
What we do is we create obstacles that creates a way that we don't just be ourselves. We live in fear. We live in gratification instead of exaltation and spiritual compassion and focus.
Now we speak of light as a spiritual concept, but we know now today from the work of Dr. Fritz Popp in Germany and others that science has proven the DNA in each of our cells emits specific levels of light, that when our health is diminishing, that light is dimming. When our health is coming back up, that light vibration is coming back up.
Everything in our lives we have contributed to, other people have contributed to, but if I want to change my life, I don't need to change you. I need to see how I contributed to this problem and make that change within myself.
Right. When the physical body is in pain, in turmoil, the emotional body follows suit. So you can't separate one from the other.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Dream time, anthropologists use that word dream time.
Yes.
But in our language we say tilkupa.
Uh-huh.
And it relates us to all things as one.
In ancient wisdom, heart houses the mind and the soul. So the heart is the boss of mind. How about who is the boss of the heart? Soul,
yes.
Spirit.
Yes, open. We have to be open, we have to be willing to trust, we have to be ready to receive, and then we have to have the courage to share.
Share.
Because if Michelangelo hadn't shared his paintings, if Mozart hadn't shared his music,
yes.
If I hadn't shared my 27 books,
yes.
We wouldn't be having this conversation.
Right.
You and I both know that it's almost impossible not to get enough protein. If you eat sufficient calories and you had a varied diet of fruits, vegetables, grains, there are amino acid chains that make
yeah.
up a complete protein.
Yes,
the only problems regarding protein in people's diets are too much protein.
Now, in the U.S., we've been educating consumers about the health dangers of genetically engineered bovine growth hormone, which is injected into cows to increase milk supply, but increases a risk factor for cancer in the milk.
And so we're not eating fresh food, we're not eating anything that's healthy or nutritious. And so until we deal with that, the rest of it we're just playing with.
And so when you increase the energy, the frequency of your body and your cells in your body by putting energetic food into it, then it raises the potential for that immune system to then fight the disease and conquer it.
Well, polyphenols are the olive oil family's chemicals of choice to fight stress, and a particular type of stress called oxidative stress.
Half the hyperactivity problems would be erased, would be cured, if children were going to be organic. And that's been my clinical experience as well.
Veggies, fruits, nuts, and seeds.
Chapatti, thank you for teaching us to be healthy.